Hello everyone and welcome back. So here we will first take a look onto the API gateway. So API gateway, we have created our own custom Node.js implementation. Okay, and what do we have in API gateway is simple. The set of APIs like account APIs, CRM APIs, and if you go to server.js, we are using this common library. Let me just talk about it. API gateway.js. So we are actually accessing this service registry from this library, which is nothing but getting a database connection. Okay, so at API gateway level, whenever the request is coming, what we are doing, we are trying to find the service by the service name or the endpoint. Okay, service registry dot find. So whenever the request is coming to the API gateway, it will try to find, okay, do we have this service already available in the service registry? If not, then service not found, simple, right? If yes, then send, we already have the payload of the service. So it can be a simple your database query, because here we are not creating the actual API gateway, which these cloud vendors are providing, AWS API gateway, Azure gateway and all. We are just trying to orchestrate the same kind of a scenario. So it's a simple Node.js service. Your request will come. Based on your request, you will actually create the API gateway object. Here you can see the post request is coming. So you are actually creating the API gateway instance and then doing a send request. So send request we have already defined in the API gateway prototype. So this is API gateway is a function. We have send method there. Before sending the request to that particular service, what we are doing is first we are trying to get the service. Okay, based on the service name and service endpoint, we already know we are requesting for order service, we are requesting for user service, auth service, all these service. Once I get the service, I will look into registry. So if you look at our architecture, which we have created in the previous video, this is the API gateway Node.js service will look into service registry. This can be a simple microservice or some kind of a Node.js endpoint or some kind of a code which you have written somewhere, which is talking to the database and coming to know that, okay, this service exists or not. We are doing simple find, which can be a mongodb.findById or something. Once we got the service endpoint, we will just hit the same payload, we will send the same set of headers which we are getting from the client to that endpoint. Okay, if we are getting error, we will just send it to the error middleware, or we are going to send the status code to the client. So similarly, we have like for the login, whenever the request is coming to the login, whenever the request is coming for the sign up, if request is coming for the orders. So these are like three different you can say the APIs we have created, and in the API gateway, here we are just getting the instance of API gateway and doing a find operations and sending this request to the right candidate. So here in the config, we have already defined, this should be a main config here. So what we have defined here is the endpoints. Okay, so there may be a login module, sign up module, order modules, right? These are different modules. Okay, and these are services. And this is just a service registry configuration. Okay, this is service registry database information. So here, if service log is coming, request for service log is coming, we will send it to this endpoint. Okay, and at modular level, if the route is coming at the login, we will hit API account and route will be account login. So it is kind of an internal mapping we are doing at route level, right? So if API is coming, request for API is coming, request for services are coming, this is how they are getting redirected. This is just a small orchestration of creating a custom API gateway using Node.js service, which will look into your request. Based on that, it will route to a particular handler. The only addition we have done here is we have the API gateway and service registry, which holds the current record of all the services which are currently up and running. If any service, so like login services there, if I go into this, so here also it has a service registry access. Whenever any particular service is being created or being dying, so here you can say server.create service registry dot, we should be creating some kind of a record whenever the service is coming up. You can say register server, what it is doing is it should be creating you can see database, and it should be creating a record in the service registry module, right? It is just trying to check if the service is up and running, just populate the record in the database. So whenever any other service is looking for that service, then okay, this is active. Similarly, there is an unregister, right? What unregister is doing, you are passing all the configurations and it will just simply unregister from service registry module. Okay, so service registry, if I look into this, so it is just a MongoDB configuration. It is giving you the connection object and it is just doing a insert or addition of record. That's it. So if you are populating a new service, then service ID, service host, service port, endpoint, service protocol, HTTP, HTTPS, TCP, all these things we are maintaining, which is nothing but creating a record in the MongoDB database. It's just a concept. Don't look into the database, but don't look into the code. But whenever you need to orchestrate some kind of a thing, you can think about this kind of a design to achieve this. This is already available on the GitHub. You can actually do the setup using npm install and just need a MongoDB. It is starting all the HTTP services. Then you hit the service on the API gateway. It will redirect the traffic to the respective services. Okay. Thanks everyone.